Alright, good day everyone. Welcome to Prime World Tutorials and to the second video of how to create an animated story in PowerPoint. It's a series and this is the second video. Now, in the last video, we created the graphic elements for the animated story. We just created the graphic elements. And in this video, we will be adding animation to some of the elements, like the three stars and the moon. So let's go to our reference to see what we are talking about. So in the reference, when we go to animations, go to the animations pane, and we preview the animation, this is what we see. We go to preview. Now you can see those animations that just played. You can see that it's still playing. So we want to replicate this in our fresh work. Now, let me just explain a bit the concept of animation. Now, if you look at these elements, you see that they have numbers attached to them. You see that the star has one, this other star has one, this one has one, this one has one. These kids are playing has two. The at night has one. They all have numbers attached to them. These numbers refer to the animations. They are like the animations that have been appended to them. Now, the one that carries the number one means that the animation will play first before the other one that carries the number two. So that is what it's talking about. Now, if you can see, the three stars have the same numbers, 1, 1, meaning that they are all playing at the same time. Okay, they are all playing at the same time. If I preview it again, you see that the stars and the moon, they came at the same time, and that is why they have 1, 1 appended to them. So that's just to give you a bit of an understanding of what is going on. So we want to replicate this on our fresh work on the graphic elements we created earlier. So let's just get to it. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go to the animations menu, this one that says animations, okay? And the first thing we want to do, we want to make the animation pane visible. It will make understanding the animation process easier. So we click on animation pane, and you can see that this pane appears. Now you can see that there is no animation showing here because we've not appended any animation to any of the objects. Now, upon being in animation, you can see that we have these different options. We have the none, appear, fade, fly in, floating. Now, if I go and click on this particular arrow here, it is going to expose more options. These are the different animation options we have in PowerPoint. We have the animations for entrance. We have the animations for emphasis. We have the animations for exit. So these are the categories of animation we have. And we also have here more entrance effects. If I click here, it will give me more options for entrance animations. Okay. And the same goes for the emphasis and more exit effects. It gives you more options. There's also options for motion parts if you want to create custom motions. We are going to look at this later on. Now, the first thing we want to do is we want to start giving animations to these objects. So let's go to the first star. So we click on the first star. Okay. And for us to give the same animation, we have to go to our reference. Okay. And notice the animation we gave for this first star. Now, as I clicked on this first star, you can see that the animation that is active in this first star is the one that is called fly in. It's called fly in. So that's the same animation we want to append, okay, to this first star. So we go to our work and we give it fly in. Now, if you notice, the thing flew from bottom to top. And now, if you also notice, if you come to the animation pane, there is an option now because we have just appended an animation to one of the elements. Now, we want to change the the we want to change the effect options of this star to suit our choice. Now for us to change the effect options, we can just click right click here and go to effect options to change it. But to use our reference as a guide, let's go and see the options we put in our reference. So clicking this star, we go to, you can see that it is this one that is active. So we go to the effect options for this one, and now you can see that we have three menus here. We have the menu for effect, timing and text animation. So on that effect, you can see that the direction is from top, no longer from bottom. We chose from top. We didn't give any timing to the smooth start and smooth end, and we gave a bounce end of 1.44 seconds. Okay, so you can see that that bounce end means the bouncing effect it has after it plays the animation. Now so we can see that in the timing we gave it 2 seconds medium, the duration to be 2 seconds medium, and we gave it to be on click. We are going to explain this concept later, very soon. Now let's do something similar to our actual work. So we come to, we click on this option, go to the effect options, and we change it, the direction from bottom, we change it to from top. Okay, then the bounce end, we want to give it a bounce effect. So let's give it a bounce effect of, let's just say, you can give it any number you want depending on how it's pleasing to your sight, how it suits you. So we give it a bounce end of 1.5 seconds. Then timing, we give it on click, and you can see that it is in 0.5 seconds, so it's very fast. So we want to make it to 2 seconds medium, so we press OK. Now you can see the effect that is playing now. Now let's go back. I didn't notice any bounce effect, it didn't bounce. So let's check the effect options to be sure that that's okay. You can see that the bounce end did not. So let's give it a bounce end again. I gave it 1.5. let me press OK. Now did you see that bounce effect? Yes, that's what we are looking for. So let's play it again to see it. Yes, that's the bounce effect we are looking for. So I wish there was an option to copy and paste an animation, since we want to do the same thing to this remaining two, but there's no option like that. We have to quickly repeat the same step we took. So we click on the second option. I'm just going to be faster this time to apply it. Come here, effect options, give it to from top, bounce end, give it 1.5, timing, now give it 2 seconds medium, then we press OK. Now so let's preview this one. If you want to preview a particular animation, just click on the on the animation here and press play from. So let's see how it goes. Wow, I think the effect options also didn't show. I don't know why it goes away. So we give it 1.5 again. Let's go to the timing. I don't want it to rewind when done playing. Go to OK. Yes, that's what we are looking for. So we come to this third one too and do something similar. Fly in, go to the effect options for this third one. This one is for this third one. So we go to effect options, make the bounce end 1.5, make the direction from bottom to from top. Then we go to timing, we go to duration, go to 2 seconds, press OK. Let's see that. Okay, you can see that the bounce end seems, we need to keep repeating the bounce end for it to be active. So we press OK. Yes, that's what we are looking for. Now, if you can remember from our reference, they all played at the same time. But if you see now, if I play it from the beginning, if I come here and press preview, and I press preview, look what happens. It is playing one at a time, second, third. We don't want that to happen. We want it to play at the same time. We want these three stars to play at the same time. So how do we make it play at the same time? Currently, it has 1, 2, 3. We want it to be 1, 1, 1. So how do we do that? This is the animation for this first star. This is the animation for the second star. So all we need to do is to come to this second star, okay? Click on this arrow here, and we see this option that says start with previous. So this option is telling us we want the animation to start with the previous element that is animated. We want it to start with the previous, meaning that to start at the same time with the previous one. So we click start with previous. Now if you notice, now it has become one. It is now the same one with this one. So we do it for the same, for we do the same thing for this third one. We choose start with previous, meaning that to start with the previous one, this second one, the animation will start with this one. And since this one is starting with the first one, it will also be appended one, the animation one. So if I preview it now, you see that they are all playing at the same time. So that's what we are looking for. So let's now do the animation for the moon. So let's go and see from our reference the kind of effect we gave for the moon. So we go to animation, we gave it a flying also. Let's see the effect options. We also gave it from top. We gave the bounce to be 0.36 seconds. We gave the timing to be 1 second fast. So we know what we want to do in our actual work. So we come here, give it a fly in, come to this place, give it effect options, change it to from top, give it a bounce end of, let's say 0.3. You can give it any bounce end you want. Let me leave it at 39 seconds. Give it a timing of 1 second and press OK. Do you see that? So that is the animation we've just appended to the moon. Now we notice from our reference that the moon also played at the same time with the star, so we will make it to start with previous. So it's starting with previous. So let's play what we've done so far. So do you see that? You can see that they played at the same time. So the next thing we want to look at now is we want to go to our reference and look at the animations we added to the, okay, at night too. We gave it, we want to see the animation we added to at night because it's also playing at the same time with the star and the moon. So at night, as I clicked on at night, you can see that we gave it a fade animation. Now let's go to the effect options to see this, the settings we gave to them. Now we said animate text all at once. We gave the option to animate the text all at once, so the fading effect will apply to the text all at once. Then we go to the timing. We gave it a timing of 2 seconds medium. Okay, so let's go and effect that on our actual work. So we go to at night. Okay, then we give it a fade animation. Then we come here to the at night text, go to effect options, effect all at once. Okay, it's already at all at once. You can decide to give it a sound if you have any sound option. You can decide to give it a sound, or you can give it this preset sounds here that PowerPoint has, or you can decide to give it a sound from your own, a custom sound from your own computer. You just click on other sounds and go to the place where you saved the sound and insert it there, but we don't want to do that now. So we go to timing, we give it 2 seconds medium, then we press OK. Now it has delayed the timing of the fade. Okay, Now we want to make it start with the previous animation, which has an animation of 1, the moon. So we go to start with previous. So you can see that it is going to be playing at the same time with these ones. Now let's go to our reference and see the animation we gave to kids are in bed sleeping. So we also gave kids are in bed sleeping a fade option. Let's go to the effects options. Now in the effect options, in the animate text, we said it should animate by letter, not all at once, by letter. So by letter just simply means that the fade effect will effect first on a letter before it goes to the next letter till you go to the end of the sentence, not all at once. If it's by word, it will affect a word, then go to the next word, then go to the next word, just like that. So we want to make it by letter. We made it by letter in our reference, so we'll make it by letter in our actual work. So timing, you can see we gave it a 2 seconds medium timing. So let's go and do something similar to our actual work. So we go to kids are in bed, give it a fade effect, go to the effect options, give it by letter, animate text by letter, 10% delay, timing, give it 2 seconds, I believe. Or should we make it 3 seconds? Okay, let's make it 3 seconds. Then I press OK. Then now you can see that it's playing. It's currently playing. Are in bed playing. Okay, so it's doing it by letter. Okay, so let's go to our reference to see if we appended any other animation. Now if you look at this background, it has an animation of 2. If you look at it, it has an animation of 2. So it's also playing at the same time with these 2. So let's know the kind of animation we put for this background. Now upon clicking on it, you can see that the option of object color is active. So we gave it an animation of object color. And object color is under emphasis animation category. It's under emphasis animation category. So we gave it object color. The object color means it will change to a new color when the animation is taking place. So let's go to the effect options and see the effects we gave it. Okay, we said that the color should change from light blue to this dark blue. Okay, and we said it should stay dark blue after animation. Then in the timing, we gave it a timing of 5.5 seconds, but I think we are going to give it the same timing as the one for kids are in bed. So let's go and effect it now. So make sure you click on the background of, that is the blue background, the blue sky background. Then we go to the option that says object color. Look at it here. Just scroll down and you click on it. So we go to the effect options. You can see that it changed to orange, but we want it to change to dark blue. So we go to effect options. So you can see that the current color is orange. So we want it to be dark blue. So we choose the blue. And we don't want it to dim, we want it to stay the same after animation. Then the timing, we want the timing to be 3 seconds. Let it play at the same pace with the previous animation, which is kids are in bed playing. So we press OK. And you can see the animation for it. So this is, we have, then the next thing we want to do, you can see that it has an animation number of 3, but we want it to play at the same time with these 2, with these kids are in bed playing. So all we need to do is to go to the option for the rectangle, the animation option for the rectangle. Don't right click, just click on this, left click on this arrow and choose start with previous. So you can see that it now has a number of 2, the same number with these kids are in bed playing. So this I believe we've added all the animation we need to add to this graphic work. So let's play it from beginning. If you want to play it from beginning, you just click on this first slide and just click on play from. Then let's see what happens. You can see that it's playing. Do you see that? Wonderful. You can see that it's playing. So this is the animation effect for this graphic work. We have successfully added animation effects to some of the elements in this graphic work. In our next video, we are going to be creating the second slide in this our reference, this second slide. We are going to be creating the graphic work for this second slide. So thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.